very good morning to you. Here's another modern parable for you to consider. A professor of business strategy started his lecture to a large group of young businesswomen and men, all of them bright sparks in their respective fields. He began his lecture by placing a bucket on the desk in front of him, and then he placed a number of rocks in the bucket. "Is this bucket now full?" he asked his audience. "Yes," they chorused in reply. So he then placed some smaller stones in between the big rocks. "Is it full now?" "Yes," they replied. So he then poured sand into the bucket, which filled the spaces between the rocks and the stones. "Is it full now?" "Probably not," some replied. So he then poured water into the bucket and asked the young people, "What is the point of this demonstration?" One smart young guy answered, "No matter how full your schedule is, you can always fit someone else in." "No," said the professor. "If I had put the sand in first, there would have been no room for the stones and rocks. In fact, if I had filled it with the small stones, there would have been no room for the larger rocks." The lesson here is, put the big rocks into the bucket of your business, in fact, into the bucket of your life. Then there will be room for the smaller stones, the sand, and so on. We have to get our priorities right in life. What are your priorities? How do they pan out in your day-to-day living? After nearly 83 years of experience and probably 65 years of wrestling with my priorities, I have decided on the following list. Firstly, God. Always the biggest rock in my bucket. Jesus said, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and everything else will fall into its right place." Secondly, family. This is the next big rock, and here my marriage comes before my children only just because a bad marriage impacts negatively on children. Parents, in-laws, extended family and friends are all smaller rocks and gravel. Thirdly, my vocation, my work, my calling, whatever your calling might be. Fourthly, church. Not to be mistaken for God. I mean the institutional church, its work and function. For me, vocation and church are intermingled, but not necessarily so for you. Fifthly, other good endeavours such as service, organisations and the like. And then six, myself. Don't underestimate self. Jesus says, love your neighbour as yourself. If you do not have a sense of self-worth and identity, you won't be very good at loving your neighbour. Let us pray. Lord God, help each and every one of us to get our priorities in life in the right order. You, Lord, know us inside out. Please guide us to put the important things in first, to put the big rocks into the bucket of our life first, and then find room for the smaller ones and the less important claims on our time and effort. This we ask through Jesus Christ, King and ruler of our lives. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you today. Amen.